Hooray! You're moving to Charleston, South Carolina. Good for you. Now what? Well, there's 11 steps that you can take that'll make your move even less stress than you think. And I'm going to reveal those in a few minutes because right now, the time that we're living in, you need all the help you can get. And I'm about to get started right now. Hi, my name is Michael Fenwrick, and I'm a realtor here in Charleston, South Carolina for the agent-owned realty company. And if this is your first time coming to our channel and you're relocating or you're moving to Charleston, South Carolina, and you want to get some information about everything that living and eating and playing in the Charleston area, please hit the subscribe button, click the bell. That way you'll be notified every time a new video is posted, and we post those once a week. Or you can go ahead and give us a call, give us a text, send us an email or a snail mail or anything of those nature. However you want to do it, just contact us, because we're here for you. The first thing you want to do to have a stress-free move to Charleston, South Carolina is, number one, get rid of some things. Go into your closets, go into your attic, go into your pantry, get rid of all those things that you haven't touched within the last year. Things that you don't really want to bring here. All those t-shirts from Jamaica and all those type of things. The kayak that you bought at the thrift store that you were going to repair but you never got around to it. Things that you don't want to spend a lot of money packing up and bringing here just to find out that you don't need it or you don't want it. Please, get rid of those things. Those pants in the back of the closet that you were going to lose weight in order to and you were going to fit into, you're not going to do it. Forget it. Throw them away. Do not bring those things with you. Anything that's broken, anything that's soiled. Like I said, if you haven't touched it in the last year, jettison. Second thing, a parts box. A parts box is a small toolbox that has screwdriver, hammer, pair of pliers, ratchet wrench, anything of that nature, Ziploc bags, and a marker. Anything that you take apart, label it, put it in the parts box. Once you're finished, bring the parts box with you. Do not let the moving company move that box. That box belongs to you. When those items get here, then you have the parts box with you. You can go ahead and put things together. The third thing is to plan your move way ahead of time. You know when you're going to be here. You're supposed to be here on the 1st of August. Okay, now's the time to start planning your move. Get a timeline. Everything that's going to be affected by your move needs to be on that timeline. The schools, the post office, you know, your doctors, all of those things, your prescriptions, all of those things need to be taken care of so that when you move, they move with you and everything is taken care of. Do not wait until the last minute. It'll only drive you crazy. Number four is temporary storage, a pod. Pod's a great container invention. They bring the container to you, they drop it off in your driveway. You pack it up with your things. You call them up, they bring it, they store it in their facility. When you're ready for it, they deliver it to you. What could be better than that? And it's cost effective as well. Plus, you can go get your own boxes, go to a liquor store or a grocery store or a furniture store or anybody of that nature and get the boxes, get your materials, go to U-Haul. They have boxes as well and tape and things that it might save you a lot of money by doing that. Plus, speaking of boxes, you go to the liquor store and get those boxes that where the wine came in. You can go to the World Market. They have plenty of them. Get those boxes. Take the wine bottles out, put your glasses in those slots. It's a lot easier and a lot safer to ship your glasses. Number five is utilities. If you are selling your house where you're moving from and you move here from Schenectady and then you get here, make sure you follow up to be sure that those utilities at your old house have been actually transferred into the new owner's name and do not continue to carry your name. You don't want to have the state of Pennsylvania sending you an electric bill after you've been here a month and a half because the names didn't get changed. Number six is research the moving company. The company that's going to be responsible for all your household items, you need to make sure that they're insured. Are they bonded? Can they be trusted? Look at their Yelp. Look at their reviews. Call somebody up that maybe they've used them. Find out. Look at the small print before you sign any agreement or any contract with this company. And please, please, please do not base your decision on because they have the cheapest price. Trust me,
The cheapest price goes sour with poor quality.
Number 8, all the big ticket items that you're not going to bring with you, donate or have a yard sale. Okay? You're having a yard sale. All those things that you're not going to bring with you, sell them. And if they don't sell at the yard sale, drop them off, donate them, give them away, or throw them away. But do not pay to have them shipped here and then come to find out you don't want them or you don't need them. It doesn't make sense. You're losing money and you waste money. You don't want to do that end time. Number 9, temporary housing. Temporary housing, VRBO, Airbnb, in-town suites, something of that nature, a short-term rental. If you're having a house built and you're moving here and for whatever reason, the house is not ready to be moved into, and so now you have to figure out where you're going to stay. You want to make sure that there's availability before you come. You can call them, set up an appointment, set up a reservation with the VRBO or the Airbnb or whoever. Set up and ask, tell them what the situation is, okay? And use them as a last minute resort, because you don't want to get here and come to find out that you can't move into your house yet for whatever reason. I mean, the countertops didn't arrive, or your project manager's cat got pregnant. He don't know who the father is, and he's all freaking out. So it's just, what I'm saying is that it's better be safe than to be sorry, okay? And plus, speaking of the builder, check with the builder. He might have a way to move you into one of the apartments. There are some of these builders, some of these subdivisions that they're building, they're building apartments on them at the same time. It could be that you can ask them if your house is not available when it's supposed to be closed, if there's a possibility that you can move into one of those apartments. Hey, if you don't ask, the answer is always no, right? Exactly. 10, find your tribe. Go to Meetup, meetup.com, okay? Meetup.com, and when you find out there might be somebody here that goes kayaking like you like, sailing, photography, somebody that likes to drink wine, somebody that's got a small business, somebody who wants to learn all about real estate investment, anything, knitting, crocheting, any of those things. There are people that have the same common denominator that you do. If you go to meetup.com, you'll find out who those people are. So when you get here, you get yourself settled in, and you know when the meeting is going to be, you know when they're going to get together. You go, you introduce yourself, boom, now you've got friends. You've already got somebody, and you've got somebody here that you have something in common with that's already lived here. This makes sense to you, makes sense to me. Now, number 11, which is the most important of all, pay attention. Number 11 is get in touch with me. Why do I say that? I've had my license since 2006. I've lived here since 2002. I know a little bit about the area. I've made great contacts here. My network system is huge. So if you need somebody, use me as a resource. You need a contractor. You need a roofer. You need a lawn guy. You need a pool guy. Anything of that nature, electrician, plumber, something of that nature, please give me a call, send me an email, send me a text. It's just that simple. I want to be able to help you make this move as smooth as possible. So until our next video, please be safe. And above all, always remember, you belong in Charleston.